Kelsey's going to pass out there. It's going to be intercepted. The Tigers have intercepted. Oh, no, he's dead. Yes, he did. Oh, my goodness. He threw the ball. The three Tigers have intercepted. And the Tigers have just intercepted the pass.
That's been our finest hour. Huge game against a great opponent, last year state champion, who beat us 31-0. And, you know, realistically, we were just hoping to close the gap and see how much more we had improved. You go into every ball game wanting to win, but, I hats off to our guys. They gave a tremendous effort. They were focused all week. They've been talking about this game for a long, long time, and we were a little worried about it, you know. They were going to lose focus in some other games.
And the Tigers now making their way out onto the field.
They were determined, and they went out there and played their hearts out. And, we made more big plays than they did, and we came away with a huge, huge win. Well, we started out the game on defense. We forced them into a punting situation, and then we took possession. And we knew that we wanted to go deep with a play-action pass on the first play of the game, and we didn't block it so well, so they sacked us.
Peyton Massey takes the snap.
And we ended up punting the ball on that series, and Peyton got off a great punt. We missed a few tackles, and they returned it all the way back to the 11-yard line. Jalen Turner made a great play just to save a touchdown there. And we ended up bowing our necks there, and then we blocked a field goal on fourth down and scooped it up and ran it back to about our 30-yard line. And even my wife told me after the game that that was the play of the game that turned it around that early. And it turned it around, but it also gave us big-time confidence.
And a huge run back, and all of a sudden the Tigers are in business.
Because then we went right down the field and scored once we took possession, and then it was game on. And, even though it was 7-7 at halftime, our guys were jacked up. We went in there and just explained that we've taken everything that they can deliver. There's nothing else they can do to us. You know, and we came out and built a 21-7 lead there in the third quarter. And then we had to hang on for our dear lives in the fourth quarter because they mounted a comeback. And, it was just our big-time players were making big-time plays all ball game. You know, Jalen Turner scored one touchdown by land, one touchdown through the air, but he also saved a touchdown on that first punt return back in the first quarter. So our guys just played phenomenal. I'm very proud of them. I mean, you look at Javoris Grant was the one that blocked the field goal. He's also the one that had the big interception in the fourth quarter. Tamarcus Young made 10 tackles on defense, but he rushed for 66 yards, and he sealed the deal with that last 30-yard run and got it out to midfield before we could kill the clock.
He's fucking to the 40! Look at him run like crazy!
Well, our defensive coaches played most of the night with four defensive linemen instead of three like we typically do to stop their run game and to give us a little bit more beef in there, and it worked out great. And if their starting quarterback would have stayed in the ball game, our game plan was more geared towards him. You know, he didn't come back in after halftime, but the one series, and their backup, who was their leading receiver, the kid that transferred in from Madison County, who was a former quarterback himself, he made us readjust again in the second half. I mean, he was a threat with his feet and his arm. And he made that thing interesting, especially on that last drive. He kept running those quarterback draws, and they kept executing it and making big yardage. And then, Javoris makes that tremendous interception down there inside the 5-yard line. But we had to make a couple of first downs. You know, we didn't want to give the ball back to them. And, you know, give credit to our offensive line. They're getting better and better every week. You know, our starters are Darrell Ware, Ken Johnson, Tony Harris, Nikita Fair, Brandon James, and they made some big holes all night, but look what they did, you know, that last drive there, getting those two huge first downs. Well, we've only played six games. We've got four more left to play. Right now, we're in the driver's seat for the number one seed, but we've got to continue playing ball. We go to Green this week. They're 2-3 overall. 1-1 in the region, and they were a playoff team last year, so you can't have a letdown. And then next week we play Rabun, who's presently undefeated in the region right now and undefeated overall. They play Jefferson this week. If Jefferson beats them and Rabun were to come in here and beat us, it'd be a three-way tie for first, and you go by a coin flip. If they beat Jefferson, then when they come in here in 2 weeks, then that's the region championship. So our, you know, our goals and dreams haven't been met yet. We're flawless through six games. We've knocked off a defending state champion, which is a big hurdle, but we've got to keep pressing on. Greene County was really struggling, but after our game, they got hot and ended up being the fourth seed from this region last year as a playoff team. And I expect them to be a whole lot better in year two. They've won two out of their last three ball games, and it's homecoming over there, so they know what it's like to play Washington Wilkes, and you know, we can't afford a mental letdown, and that's what we've got to guard ourselves against all week long, is no mental letdowns, because they're athletic enough where they can hit some big plays and really turn a game around.
My name is Alex Moore, and I'm the inside linebackers coach here at Washington Wilkes. This is my third year at Washington. I've been around football my entire life. My dad was a coach. I actually played for Coach Robinson in my playing career. I went to Georgia Southern University, and I coached 2 years there, previously at Southeast Bullock High School and at Claxton High School. My favorite part of the job is getting to work with the young men that we get the experience of spending our days with and teaching them the game of football and the game of life, and how to be successful in each of those. Go!